we will discuss the full outer joint. Now, just like the right outer joint and the left outer joint, the full outer joint means it gives liberty, full liberty to both the tables. The right outer joint gave liberty to the right side tables. The left outer joint gave liberty to the left side tables. What was the liberty? The liberty was that irrespective of the fact whether the matching column, whether the common columns have matching values or not, the table had the liberty to keep all the tuples in the resultant table. If it was the left outer joint, liberty was given to the left side table to keep all the tuples in the resultant table, whether or not they have matching values for the common column. Similarly, the right outer joint gave liberty to the right side table to keep all the tuples in the resultant table, whether or not they have matching values for the common column. So, the full outer joint, by now it must be clear from the name itself that the full outer joint means it gives liberty to both the tables. That is the full liberty, irrespective of the fact whether or not the common column has matching values, you will keep all the tuples from both the tables in the resultant table. Okay. And just like the left or right outer joint, wherever you do not have matching values, you will simply put null in front of that column, but you will keep all the tuples in the resultant table. Now let's have a look at the example of this. So this is our example for the full outer joint. See, full outer joint, again we have same tables, the table R and table S. Now table R has two columns, the employee name and the department ID. Similarly, table S has two columns, the department ID and the department name. Alright, so we have two tables, R and S. Now since it is the full outer joint, we will not consider any one table, but we will consider both the tables. That means here, both the tables have the liberty to keep all their tuples in the resultant table. We don't have to be bothered about whether the matching column, common column, has matching values or not. Whether or not the common column, that is the department ID, has matching values or not, we will keep all the tuples of both the tables in the resultant table after performing the join. That is the right, that is the full outer join. So, now we have two columns in the table R, which is employee name and department ID. Similarly, we have two columns in the table S, department ID and the department name. Now again, you know it's quite obvious which is the common column. The department ID is the common column. Okay, now let's perform the full outer join on the tables R and table S. After we perform the full outer join, first of all, we will copy all the columns. Yes, the employee name, the department ID and the department name. Now let's perform the full outer join. First, we will start from the first tuple. So what is the first tuple? Employee name A, department ID 1. In the second table, first tuple is department ID 1 and department name D1. So here we have matching values for the common column. Yes, both the department ID in both the tables has same value, that is 1. That is, we have matching value for both the columns. So we will copy A 1 and D1. So the first tuple is copied. Now let's move on to the next tuple, that is the second tuple. Now let's see, employee name is B, department ID is 2 over here. Then the department ID is 3 over here and the department name is D3. Okay, now let's match the common column, values of the common column. In the second tuple, the common column for R, that is the department ID for R is 2. Whereas the department ID for S is 3. So is this a matching value? No, this is not a matching value. But since it is a full outer join, what we will do? We will copy the values B2, and there is no matching value for the department name, hence we will write null. Okay, now let's move on to the next tuple, that is the third tuple C1. Here the common column, there is department ID 1 and department ID 1. So we have matching values for the common column department ID. So what we will write? C1, and what is the department name for DID 1? D1. So we will write it over here. Now let's look at the second tuple of the table S. For this, the common value 3, common column 3 has no matching value anywhere. So that means there is no employee name for this particular tuple in the table R. So what we will do, we will write null here. We will copy department ID 3 and department name D3. So this is as simple as the right outer join and the left outer join. You just have to take care of the fact that wherever there is no matching value for the common column, you will simply write null over there. But you will write all the tuples of both the tables in the resultant table.